when family members are acting in an extremely negative manner, even dangerous towards one, okay, how can that act after years of patience and pain? How can one act, I guess? Abuse is abuse. And Islam does not tell you to be patient against abuse. If you're being abused, then you have to take action and do something about it. It doesn't matter if it's from your parents, or from your husband, or from your wife. You have to take action, you have to protect yourself. It's a matter of sometimes protecting children. You have to do whatever it takes to protect the children. Safety comes first. And if there are situations of danger, then don't say there's a religious verdict or you're not a good Muslim if you, you know, if you spoke up about it or you tried to do something about it. There's no such thing. That's entirely bogus. It's entirely bogus. There's no such thing. You know, it's dumb that you might think that some wife is being beat by her husband and she goes to the imam and the imam says, well, you know, it's just ibadah for you. You should just have sadaqah. No, no. That is not this religion. I don't know what religion that is, but it's not Islam. It's not Islam. We have no tolerance in our religion for abuse. There is none. The words of the Prophet ﷺ against abusers are very harsh. The Prophet ﷺ wouldn't even tolerate abuse against an animal. Rasulullah ﷺ cursed the one who, he saw the smack mark on a donkey, and he said, well, I cursed the one who did this. He couldn't stand an animal being slapped on the face. An animal being slapped on the face. It's not something that we take lightly. And that's physical abuse. It's not a joking matter. Seek help. And even if it's anonymous somehow, you're going to go to Kufar for help? Yes, go to Kufar for help, and Muslims are helping you. And if their professionals are helping you, then seek the help. Seek the hotlines. If you can find a Muslim counselor, well and good. But protect yourself, protect your children, and do not allow abuse in the family, and don't let it go quiet. Don't let it go quiet. It is not something we can tolerate at all. This is the kind of thing that destroys a society from within when it's not addressed. If a spouse is abusive, do we make dua to stay with them or dua to leave them? This is not a matter of dua, it's a matter of action, sister. And I don't know how you define abusive. But if your husband's abusive, you have no reason to be with him. And I'm not telling you to go get divorced because I don't know what you mean by abuse. He's like, he came home and said, well, how come you didn't make chicken today? He's such abuse. Mark said, you know, like, bring me to your situation. Seek a counselor, first of all. Seek a counselor because this one line you said to me does not represent your situation. Your situation is a lot more complicated than this. And it's making, you know why these questions are important? Not so I can just, you know, dodge them. But it makes you realize how many of us need this stuff, man. How many counselors are needed? This is serious need of deal. You want to serve the Allah, you become a counselor. This is a really important, and by the way, don't become a counselor if you don't have a tough heart. If you're like a sensitive type, don't become a counselor. You're going to cry more than the guy who's you're not helping well. The guy got this, you're going to be spread.